It's 13 after 9. Thanks for being with us on Live at 9. Any business owner knows that to stay on top, you have to stay current. And since that can be very overwhelming, the city of Memphis wants to help local entrepreneurs do that.
A week of seminars and workshops will bring together Mid-South business owners with some titans of industry. Joanne Massey serves as the director for the Office of Business Diversity and Compliance for the City of Memphis. She's here with Senior Business Services Coordinator Taylor Tagg this morning. And we are glad to have you both here.
Good to have you.
So, Joanne, I'll start with you. What is the prognosis or the health for a lot of entrepreneurs really trying to get their start here in the city of Memphis?
Well, we really have found over the years under Mayor Strickland's administration that it's really important for businesses to receive information, guidance, and technical assistance. You know, they don't have to just go it alone. Right. And so with this, we did a survey of our businesses in January, and from that, we came up with this series of business support that we have.
A whole week of seminars. And you know, this, we were talking about this yesterday. There's a whole new design thinking process where you ask your audience, what do you need? Instead of Taylor, for instance, coming up with what you think they need. And that's essentially what you did. What did they say they need most, Taylor?
Well, based on the feedback we got from that survey, we did put together the Business Health Week, and we're gonna cover a variety of topics in 1 week, and we're going to cover reading and understanding basic financial information, how to get funding for your business as well, and then effective marketing for entrepreneurs. That's by far the number one need.
And that has to be effective but inexpensive for a startup, right?
Absolutely. We're also going to cover budgeting and also tax saving tips for small businesses.
So, Joanne, awesome. If you do not tackle those things for a lot of entrepreneurs, these can be areas of a lot of struggle for so many people out there. Can they not be?
Absolutely. We've found, in our data, in our disparity study, we found that businesses are even closing their doors because they don't have that support. Not only because they don't have access to it, but as you mentioned, because they can't afford it either.
Right.
And so that's why Mayor Strickland was so intentional about having these services offered for free from the City of Memphis. I mean, our taxpayers have already paid for this, so we're very intentional about the strategies that we developed to support businesses.
And a lot of times I think some people may hear you're just about helping minority businesses, female owned or owned by people of color. And it's not that, it's just that traditionally the Old Boys Network has gotten a lot of this information, correct me if I'm wrong, from their friends, from their schoolmates, from their families, and women and others who are not traditional business owners have not. So somebody else has to step in, yes or no? Taylor?
Yes, absolutely. I think we really have to cater to everyone's needs. And with Memphis being a destination for women-owned and minority-owned businesses, even small business owners as well, it's just a good opportunity for us to be able to provide additional resources to them to help them in the areas that they need the very most.
So what is the type of a business owner who really needs to come out, who really needs to be a part of this?
Well, we're asking all of our small business owners to come out. 80% of the jobs in the state of Tennessee are made by small businesses. So it's not just the historically disadvantaged businesses like minority and women-owned businesses that we're seeking to support. Right. In fact, the City of Memphis government, we have a small business enterprise ordinance that was enacted by our city council. And so we operate under that. So this is not just about, as you said, the historically disadvantaged businesses, but all businesses and all industries, regardless of what industry they're in, they can receive some input from this training.
And Taylor, paint a bigger picture for us here. If some of those smaller businesses succeed, how does this impact us all as a city, as a community?
Well, I think that number one, we want to be able to grow Memphis-based businesses and small businesses in particular. We have a hotbed of corporate America here, but also small businesses. They need to learn how to grow. And there are tremendous resources in this city now to be able to help them do that. And that's why we put on this business.
FedEx was once a small business, so we need more of them. Thank you so much.
Thank you both for being here.
On the screen. All you have to do is register.
Right. We mean business.